Hi everyone, welcome to the Rantabl channel. My name is Kamil. We are a small team of 3 people and we've been working on a horror game about Urbex for almost 2 years now. If you're discovering this channel by watching this video and notice the number of subscribers while there are no video on the channel, that's normal. We decided to make over 100 tutorial videos about game development, private, and focus the channel content only on our game. In this video, I want to show you how we optimize the demo of our game, which will be available very soon on Steam. Make sure to wishlist the game to stay updated on its release. Of course, this will be a quick summary of the optimization process of our demo and won't include every possible optimization technique. First, to optimize your game on Unreal 5, the most important and easiest thing is curling. By adding a curl distance volume to our project, we could optimize the game by making 3D models disappear when they are out of the camera view. This is very important because when if the player can't see the 3D model, the computer still does and continue to process them for the rendering. But with curling, we make those models disappear with custom settings based on the distance between the mesh and the player. Often some high polygon mesh still need to be visible, and for that we use the level of details to improve performance. With LOD we don't make the model disappear but reduce its quality as the player moves away from it. To keep improving performance, we paid close attention to the texture we used. The higher the texture resolution, for example for key, the harder it is to optimize your project. Of course, if the player have a good computer for playing your game, it's better to play in 4K and enjoy the full experience, but we decided to use a maximum texture resolution of 2K. This makes it faster and easier for us to optimize and improve the FPS. To reduce texture size directly in Unreal Engine 5, you can open the texture and adjust its maximum size in the setting. We also do the same for our model created in Blender, ensuring they don't exceed 2K. This might not sound impressive, but if your project has many meshes and you keep high resolution texture, your optimization will suffer. Every project is different and requires a unique approach to optimization. For our demo, which is an indoor map, things are simpler because nothing is visible in the distance. Additionally, we don't need to add outdoor lighting like the sun, which greatly reduces shadows calculating since the only light used in our project is the flashlight. However, in Urbex Murder, you'll see that there are multiple maps with the option to play in co-op, including game modes specifically designed for co-op and outdoor maps. What I mean here is that lighting also plays an important role in optimization. Even using a single flashlight with a spotlight can lower your FPS. You need to spend time fine-tuning the lighting, combining it with the post-process setting and avoiding high values for intensity or light distance with attenuation. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, there are many topics to discuss regarding optimization, and I can't cover all the possibilities. In this video, I gave you a summary of the main optimization technique we used for the demo of Urbex Murder. For our outdoor maps, the optimization work will be different. But most importantly, optimization starts with you. Don't place meshes randomly in large quantity, just make things look good. Having a lot of meshes doesn't necessarily mean it looks good. It usually means poor optimization and a less efficient workflow. You need to place your 3D models in a way that is sufficient. Our game, Urbex Murder, is on Steam. To support us and stay updated on the release, you can wishlist the game. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or join our Discord server. Thank you for watching the video.